Hot House Operatives. It's your man Cousin T, and you are now hanging with the Seducer and the Sage, where the desire to acquire gets a five-dimensional rundown. So today, I wanted to go over a brief rundown of how this system works. Basically, I receive or I select a case study for the breakdown of the episode. And basically, the requirement for a proper case study. And this will include if a person is going to request a private consultation. This is what I require in order to do a full analysis of a case study. First, I definitely need a signature picture. That means a picture that really represents who she is. Now, the name is not important. You can make up a name if you want, put out a pet name, that's up to you. Ethnicity is important. Age is important. If you have her measurements, that would be great. Height, weight, I can assess the octane grade. That'll be put out there. Where she's from, that tends to be important as well, as we'll see in this particular episode. Try to provide pictures. If you can, provide a link to her social media, either Instagram, Facebook, something that has a variety or range of her pictures, or if you just have those available that weren't stalker-based pictures, provide a picture of her sitting, provide a picture of her standing, provide a picture in her natural environment. Definitely, if there's a picture with her and a group of friends, not necessarily coworkers, but friends, definitely provide that picture. That's important when we're talking about what her ranking is within the female group hierarchy. And basically, we will do the rest. And by we, I mean the Sage and the Seducer. So gentlemen, let's get into today's case study. Today's case study is a blue check mark. People know what that is, means a certified personality from Instagram. First name is Shanika, last name starts with an A. Now this is a socialite from the Atlanta area. The first picture is the one of her sitting. Beyond the picture that was placed in the tile that really just shows off her physical attributes, I always say pick a picture or a group of pictures of the woman seated, because that's going to show you what her physicality or her size is even when seated. A lot of people who train understand that dynamic, that a person can be standing, especially a woman can be standing, she can be wearing Spanx, she could be wearing some type of shaper or form fitter when she's standing up. That'll give her that that hourglass figure when she's standing, but when she's seated, the way that gravity works will show you a better representation. Second picture we're going to show is the environment. Now, the environment in which this particular case study is in is that of a socialite. Jet set gets flown out to different locations. There are not a lot of indicators on her social media that speak to her business interests. Obviously, that's her business if she wants to keep it private or not. It looks like she distributes beauty products, in particular women's hair products, including hair. But this picture that I selected for her environmental representation shows her being spoiled, shows her quote unquote babe providing a brand new luxury vehicle for her. That's very telling and important to keep in mind. Third, when I look through the profile, I look for her interactions with other women. This is one of two women that she referred to either as babe or bestie. This shows me that she is somewhat of a loner, possible outlier, but at least a mercenary, okay? It's not a situation in which she is the type to gravitate towards a group of women. this is a very strategic positioning of herself at this time. She does not seem like the loner type, however. We'll get to that a little bit later. But a lot of women who are socialites, who want to put themselves in the proximity of the type of man who spoils her, who's able to fly her to different places, do not want to associate themselves with a large grouping of women because she doesn't want a particular type of man to think that he has to, you know, fly all of these people out, her entire group of friends, because that's a rookie mistake. Younger socialite women who are interested in displaying the parts of their physical life so much so that they aren't mindful or cognizant of how much they're oversharing. And when they show that grouping of friends, because a rookie mistake for women is to assume that a high value man looks at the women that they're in proximity with and that her beauty and attractiveness is enhanced by being in proximity to other attractive women. Whereas the more seasoned socialite, the more seasoned high value woman understands that if she is looking for a high value man for herself, she needs to be the center of attention and the focal point. So this shows a bit of maturity on the part of this particular case study. But the friend that I wanted to point out with this particular case study is one who is married and one who has the lifestyle status that she, Shanika, our case study, wants to emulate. So of course she's going to post pictures on the private jet setting somewhere. And how is the friend able to have access to these resources? Look at this supplementary picture. This is her friend's source of her lifestyle. This is the man that her friend is married to. And so we have insight in terms of her friend's source of her lifestyle. Okay, she's married to a man who has considerable resources, and so it allows her friend, and by proxy herself, to be able to indulge in the trappings of the lifestyle of a high value man. Moving forward, does a woman with this profile, who, let's just say, she's a current 100 octane, but she's transitioning out of the 100 octane position, okay? So we'll say 100. I rate her as a top mistress, okay? Because her positioning to her best friends or her bestie or bae is not that of a contemporary. It's that of she's looking up to her friend. She's looking up to the woman who can be flown out for her birthday on a private jet. She's looking up to her friend who is married, which is, you know, a testament to a queen bee or a woman who has achieved queen bee status. She looks up to that woman. So that's why I classified this case study as a top mistress. So in terms of her full score, she has currently a 100 T-9. Yes, gentlemen, I give her an overall 9 on the looks physicality scale. Obviously, as she further transitions out of the 100 octane space, only time will tell. Time and her genetics will tell whether or not she maintains that iconic status or if she goes to the classic beauty position, which is an 8. Okay, so next we have placement. Will you manage or will you entertain this person for a short term, for the short term in your life? Mid-term, meaning over a period of time in which she's in your space for a season, you know, transitioning with you through that particular point in your mission trajectory, or is she in it for the long term? Is this your queen bee? Is this the person that you're going to marry or commit yourself to if you're not into legal marriage? Those are the things that you need to keep in mind at the end of the day. So remember, gentlemen, there is a seducer and the sage inside of all of us. I'm here to bring it out one podcast at a time. As always, this is your man, Cousin T, aka the Alpha Wingman, saying stay sharp and mission focused. Later.